Day breaks in the east, and a mighty army rises. Not an army marching to the deep and desolating roar of shells, but a mighty army of builders who go forth accompanied by the whistles from America's greatest factories. While their giant smokestacks right across the skies promise of a new prosperity, in a land where that prosperity brings a fuller life to every man who labors and who serves. And as each builder marches forth to shape his destiny, tens of thousands more go with him side by side. And so each one is multiplied. And thus America has grown from the combined services of those who plan, create, and build. Each day serving better, earning more, and building greater values than can be found in any other nation of the world.
Tens of thousands of workers made a handsome living in mills that were 5, 6, sometimes 7 miles long. The incredible output of 100 million tons a year seemed almost easy.
Early in the morning, factory whistle blows. Man rises from bed and puts on his clothes. Man takes a bite, walks out in the morning light. Through the pit stops of pain, through the sweatshops of gain. See my father walking through them factory gates in the rain. Factory is his wife, factory gives him life.
Just the work, just the work in life.
It's the work, just the work in life.
Time is hard for the skating guard in the factory or the prison yard with the master's lash for the boss's cash. In the slavery days where the works don't pay, the machine guns chains still blind and the pockets lined by the legal crimes, where the I got mine is a sign of the time and the blood on line right between, I mean the lines.
Cry. Men wait at these gates with blood in their eye. And you just better believe, boy, somebody gonna get there tonight.
But my gosh, I mean, they've got restaurants and movie theaters and hospitals and swimming pools. And I mean, it's a, for a factory, it's a pretty nice factory.